Good evening to you. Today we have the Honorable Lochap Peter Kane of Bokora East in Napark District, who is going to be talking to us about the scandal of the iron sheets that were meant for affirmative action in the Karamoja sub-region but have ended up in the hands of a minister. He will be telling us details and explaining to us exactly what the scandal is about, and then talking to us about this region, the challenges they are going through, and how they would want government to help them overcome these challenges. Thank you for joining us. I am Vivian Kamsimi. Yes, you're welcome, Honorable.
Thank you very much, Vivian and the crew. I am one small chap, Peter Ken.
Yes.
Member of Parliament for Bokora East in Napark District and a member of Karamoja Parliamentary Group. I would like to welcome you to my office. That's welcome. And of course, we have been hearing, we have been actually reading from the social media, from the TV. So we have been seeing the issue of iron sheets. These iron sheets were meant for the Karashuna. We call them the young boys, those who have been disarmed.
Yes.
They were meant actually to give them as a kind of resettlement package.
Yes.
But it's unfortunate, even before any of them has received even one, their iron sheets found themselves in some other areas, like in Bugishuland. That's in Mbale.
Now, just before we get there, Honorable, can you just help us understand what Karamoja sub-region or the entire Karamoja region is?
Karamoja lies in the northeastern part of Uganda. And it consists of 9 districts. If you start naming from the mother district, Moroto, Kotido, you go to Kabong, Karenga, come to Abimu, Nakapiripirit, Napark, Nabilatuk, and Amudat. Those are the districts which make up what we call Karamoja sub-region. And of course, we are on the arid area as far as the geographical setting is concerned.
Okay. You have said that Moroto is the mother district.
Yes.
Why do you call it mother district?
We used to, before independence, we used only to have one district called Moroto. Then later, Moroto gave birth to Kotido. Now Kotido gave birth to Kabong, Karenga, Abim, while Moroto gave birth to Nakapiripirit, Napark, and now Nakapiripirit gave birth to Amudat and Nabilatu.
Okay, so Honorable, explain to us the genesis of this iron sheets scandal.
The genesis of the iron sheets scandal is actually right from the time we had the meeting with His Excellency the President in his state house, actually in Entebbe. That is way back in 21, immediately after we had been sown in. So in 2022 is when we requested for the president to assist the Karamojong with iron sheets, especially those who surrender and who surrender their guns, and then they will be resettled so that they can use those iron sheets to build their homes and have permanent resettlement. That's where the idea was conceived, that Karamoja needed an affirmative action such that they should be given iron sheets, they should be given, those boys should be given goats. And that one went on well, and we thought the process was given. For us as politicians, we handed over everything now to the Minister for Karamoja Affairs to go ahead with the whole process until the time of delivery. But it's unfortunate, when it came to delivery of iron sheets, the people have, up to now, have not even received one iron sheet.
Oh, no. Yes, you're saying that you asked the president for this affirmative action. Why? Why Karamoja region? Why Karamoja sub-region?
We are a region which is actually disadvantaged. We lack so many things. Imagine if you can go to the extent of asking the president to help out people with their own sheets. You should know really that place, first of all, does not even have grass for anybody to make a grass such hard because of the dry spell, because of the disasters we have undergone. So that was the reason we asked that maybe if this would help our youth settle. Somebody can put a small shop of ease and he or she can start living there and then.
So how many iron sheets were you supposed to receive, for example, in your district where you come from? That is Napark district.
In my district, we are supposed to have received at least over 10,000 iron sheets. We are supposed to, and we have not received even a single one. Yes.
So it is said that one of the MPs from that region whistleblew about the scandal. How did this scandal unfold from the office of the Prime Minister to the members of Parliament? Because you even convened a press briefing last week about it. Yes. How has it unfolded?
Yes, the issue of the iron sheets came about because we waited for long. And we were hearing from the corridors that iron sheets are being distributed left and right. And we could ask ourselves, has anybody of us received iron sheets? And then nobody could actually say.
Who are those who were distributing and who were they distributing?
Of course, the office of the Prime Minister was distributing. And if you saw the list in the social media, it names very high profile people. Including actually the Minister for Karamoja Affairs, who's supposed to be the custodian of all what is meant for Karamoja, was a man.
That is
Honorable Dr. Goroti Kitutu.
Yes,
she was named. And even when you saw from social media, even the mother, her mother and relatives were arrested selling those iron sheets. And even the mother promising those who came to buy that, if you feel like getting more, please you come. Take those and then you come for more. So which means they have them in excess.
Honorable, you know these are very serious allegations.
Yeah, they can be, but the truth is that they were followed and they exhibit. Those were arrested. Those are no longer allegations. Because the exhibit is already there, it's with the investigating harm of government.
Okay. So they were being distributed by the office of the Prime Minister to beneficiaries like the Honorable Goretti.
Yes, like Honorable Goretti.
Yes, who else?
The rest he knows. In fact, the prime suspect who started distributing this is Honorable Dr. Goroti Kitutu. Where they got their iron sheets even from our home. So she knows where who are other people she gave. Because now when you saw from the social media, many people are being named. Even including our junior, they also named her for having taken me. So in fact, when you see the people who are being named, most of them are ministers. So which means it had become a ministerial sort of project for them to share. Because there was no MP who was involved in this. No MP was actually got with the iron sheets.
But the Honorable Prime Minister, the Right Honorable Nabanja, has reported that the iron sheets that were given out to other regions were not meant for Karamoja. And she has also said that her office is cooperating with the investigations and the detectives that are doing the investigation in this issue where these iron sheets were deviated from where they should have gone. Are you satisfied with that action?
I am not satisfied with what the Right Honorable Prime Minister said, because why is it that that letter has been originated? Is it because the iron sheets of Karamoja have been lost? So they should have originated that letter earlier. The only letter we saw was the one of the PS, Office of the Prime Minister, actually supporting that really The iron sheets have been stolen, the investigation was taking place. So I don't see why so many letters are coming, and yet for us, we need our iron sheets.
Yes. Also, one of the things you have asked for is that the Honorable Minister resigns. Why didn't you wait for the investigation to make a recommendation like that?
For me, I would love she resigns. Because it's already a shame. What will she go and tell the people of Karamoja? Will she really have a platform to stand before them? Because whether it is what, the whole region now knows that she has actually messed up with the iron sheets, which were meant for the youth of the for the Karachun of Karamoja to benefit from. She has missed. The best for her to retain her integrity is to resign and go home, and she will be coming. She can also become a bench mark of life, the rest of us.
Okay. Is this the first scandal that is happening about this region?
This is the first one we have had. But there are many underneath which they have not been unearthed.
Do you know about them?
I know some of them because there was a time they had given sewing machines to Karamoja. All the sewing machines are nowhere to be seen. I'm told they found in their way, I don't know where. So there are so many other things which are taking place. Even the issue of goats. All the goats have not been handed over to the people. There are some other goats which have not been handed, and the money has not been accounted for. So here we call for general accountability for whatever has always been destined for Karamoja.
So you said that the goats are part of the concessions that you asked from the president with the iron sheets. Yes. And the iron sheets were actually released around the 20th of January. So were the goats also already released? Have you found out, do you have information that the goats were released from the office of
yes,
the Prime Minister at and they did not actually reach the people of Karamoja?
No, at least the goats were released. Men, some of them reached. We don't know whether that is the right number for the whole of Karamoja, which was supposed to what? Which was supposed to, the people of Karamoja were supposed to benefit. We are not sure. Because now when you see this scandal of iron sheets, imagine how do you, your mother, you start serving food to yourself before children. It is just like, you compare it to that. You start serving iron sheets to yourself. We don't know whether they also started serving goats first to themselves, and then later they brought a few for us. But it is now when we have woken up and seen, hey, things are not moving in the right direction. That's how this thing came about. So the God of the Karamojans has actually spoken, and he has brought everybody to light and to show them that whatever you have been doing in darkness can always be seen in day or light.
Do you have information about the other people who are involved in this scandal?
I really don't know, because I don't need to bring anybody whom I don't know. But Goroti, being our minister for Karamoja, should be the one actually to say, hey, I wasn't alone. I have ABCD. Because we saw she was among those who was allocating, because we don't know who was in the allocation committee of the Zion sheets. She must be the one. She must be knowing those who were in the allocation committee, because none of us was even called to witness. None of us was even called to be around to see whether the iron sheets...
Are you usually called to witness? What is the process when government is delivering relief to your region? What has always...
When government is delivering relief to our region, in most cases, we are called to go and witness, and we have witnessed. But this one, it is done quietly by a few people who know themselves and who know how to calculate and know what belongs to so and so should be this and that. For us, we did not witness this.
Okay. So how best would you want government to deal with this scandal now?
To me, I would say, personally, as a cadre of the revolution, I feel government should investigate this issue of relief items going to Karamoja deep. It should go back even to when this thing started, because if it's left just like that, people will continue taking Karamoja for granted. And Karamoja and the Karamojans would hate the government for no reason When it is the people who are supposed to manage, who are supposed to give services to Karamoja, they are the ones mismanaging. So a serious investigation must actually take place, and whoever is found guilty must be arrested and face the court of law.
Okay. Now, the Prime Minister's office handles a number of relief items that they take for livelihood for different regions, whether it is for Luwero Triangle, whether it is to do with Karamoja, your region there, whether it is the Kasese people who have had river banks breaking out and taking up some of the houses there. Why do you think Karamoja this time round has been a fertile ground for such a scandal to happen?
Yeah, Karamoja has been a fertile ground because most of the people who go there, they don't go with one heart. I want to give you an example. When the president appointed the first lady as the minister for Karamoja, we moved very well with the first lady. That time I was the chairman LC5 of the Greater Morto before the creation of NAPA. We moved very well. There were dams which were constructed in that area. Up to now, when you go and see those dams, one called Areshek, you will think it's a lake and it has water throughout, because the first lady didn't want any corruption to take place and didn't want. And there was a time for the last 10 years, the 10 years she was there, people grew a lot of food and we had even supplies to sell to our neighbors like in Teso and other areas. That was when the first lady, but it was unfortunate that really the first lady was later again transferred, actually appointed and given another docket being a minister for me. But that was for us. The first lady had brought Karamoja to, in fact, where she left, nobody has even added anything. If anything, it is only looting. There is no dam which has been added, even in terms of water. There is even no agriculture taking place seriously as it was during our time. For us, that time, the first lady was God sent to us.
So, Honorable, going forward, how do you advise government to ensure that such scandals don't happen in relief provision to Karamoja? Because even when the famine, let's say, hits, there will be food supplies there because of the climate in Karamoja. Yes.
Yeah, we would advise government that whatever goes Karamoja, really, the government should use the leadership of Karamoja. Because it's unfortunate that when some of these things are happening, we are not involved. They involve other people. Then we want also government to start identifying cadres, real cadres, who really have people at heart. Not the businessmen or businesswomen who go there to look for business other than giving services.
Why do you call them businessmen?
Yeah, I've been there, sold the sheets. They have been selling sheets instead of building, using, or them donating it to another church. Mm-hmm. They were selling. That's not the business. That was the explanatory. This is just business they are doing. So we want cadres who will go there and actually deliver services, not doing business. Because it seems we are running short of cadres, and we are now bringing everybody on board to go and survive in Karamoja. So we are not going to accept that.
Okay. Now, off to the region. The general problems of the region. Can you explain to us the challenges that these 9 districts that you mentioned that make up the Karamoja region go through? Maybe their history, how they have come through the years, because by now we would expect that Karamoja is a much better place than what it used to be maybe in the 90s up until now.
Yes, that is what I was telling you.
Yes.
That when the first lady was the minister for Karamoja, Karamoja was coming up. Immediately she was given another assignment, Karamoja started going down. And it's worsening now. There is nothing taking place. Because one, during the time of the first lady, all the raids, cattle rustling, had stopped because we had disarmed all the youth. And there were alternative, she had given people an alternative livelihood. like some generating income. The youth now were able to do some trade, buying goods, selling, you buy and sell cows, just like that. And they had abandoned the gun. So what has brought back the gun is just poverty. Because a person looks all around and sees almost nothing to survive. And they ended up what? Going back to look for wrong ways of getting livelihood, which we all discourage and we condemn. And that's why right now as we talk, this disarmament taking place in Karamoja. But it's not ending. So which means if the disarmament is not ending, then there must be a problem somewhere. You know, somewhere some other people say it is the politics, but for us politicians, we are saying we must end insecurity. And above all, there is, of course, now there is always a drought. For the last 5 years, we have been having drought. There is no rains, no food. People are dying. And even the people you see, the people who have been dying, are the young, actually the children and the elderly people. Those are the people who got affected so much. Because those are the energetic people where others have had to run. The others are in Kampala. They are where scattered in Nairobi, looking for survival. So for us, if we want the region to gain back to what it was, we must eliminate the corrupt officials.
Listening to you speaking, Honorable, it sounds like the problems of Karamoja are to do with poverty. But also, there have been cultural instances where it is said that the Karamojong people cannot settle in one place. If they move to an area and bury, let's say, 5 people there, then they can they find it that they have to move on because they think that they too could die. So isn't it more of a cultural problem of how people live in Karamoja?
No, the issues of Karamoja are not of any cultural effect. So the Karamoja now are settled people. Yes. We are now practicing what they call agro-pastoralism. So we rear both animals and we also grow crops. But because of the nature, because of the drought, at times when there is no rain, because we only actually receive rain, which comes by the means of God. We don't have any irrigation anywhere. We don't have any projects anywhere. So when there is no rain, then that year is bad for us. But when there is rain, we always harvest our food and we are always comfortable. And we have never moved from our home states we have now. We stay now in home states and we don't move up and down as used to be the case in those early 60s. In fact, what you are telling me now is what used to happen in the early 60s. The only movement which is there now is for cattle. When they move from one place to another in search of water and pasture. But at the time of rain, the rain season, they come back home. So we have settled homes. We don't move up and down.
Thank you very much, Honorable, for talking to us here. We are still here discussing the problems or challenges that are going on in the Karamoja sub-region. This is The Checkpoint. Let's take a short break.